Hello, this is SuperCat222, and welcome to another episode of Super Time! Woo! And in this video, I'm going to do another part of Worldcraft, and sorry I kept you waiting for a while, but never mind. First up, I'll just actually I'll wait until I've done made a certain amount of progress in Worldcraft. So I'm planning on having damping up to 100%. I'm going to place in pause mode so that the sack bot does not fall. Oh, just go rewind. Handy feature, isn't it? I'll just hide it there. Don't worry, I'll be able to bring it back up. Shouldn't be too long. In fact, to save time, I'm going to multi-grab. Fair. That's it to save time. Now to make this block movable, won't we? So I'm going to move my cursor over to what is going to be the Worldcraft cursor. And what it will be is that it would move over a block, and when you hold down L1, you would pick it up. Okay. So what I'm going to do is that I am going to use a remote tag sensor if I can. And on the block. No. No, not a remote tag sensor. A normal tag sensor. And I think that's almost about the average radius it would have. So I'm going to set the maximum detection range to 23. Yeah, 23 as an integer, not a float. Yeah, an integer is a whole number, and a float, by the way, is a number with a decimal point in it, for example, 1.5. Anyway. I'm going to connect the L1 button turn. So hopefully it should Only. Oh yeah, hopefully it should only activate when L1 is pressed. I'm just going to move that a bit lower. Maybe about there. So if we hold down L1 right now. Hang on. Yeah. Yeah, it seemed like that's the L1 thing working. Okay. Okay, I'm just going to create a minimum range of 8.5. Oh, no. Yeah, 10 should be enough. Okay. What is that going to have? Trying gravity tree. Quote would set thing to maybe 90%. Whereas with the other one, I'm planning on having a not gate. And let's hold on. And I'm also going to try and make it movable. So I'm going to make myself a small, simple platform. And I'm going to make it static. This is only a temp. Temporary platform. And I'm going to. Set remote control to no. Oh, only temporarily though. Okay. Hopefully, it should. Oh yeah, it should work. So hold down L1. Yeah. So I think that's pretty much got it. And head, but a duplicate follower, and I wonder if it would follow tag. Oh yeah, so follow tag. Oh, so I'm going to it's that it follows the cursor. Have a look at it. Code range. And it has to be a similar size to a cursor, like actually inside it. There. Pen for the cursor. Going to happen is that going to have it so that there's a blue tag. Oh, and then I'm going. Have it so that what's a word again? Pretty much gone now. Oh yeah, so that the grass block will be inside the cursor, I think. So I'm going to go to a goodies bag. No, actually the tools bag. That way I would be able to corner edit. Then hopefully if I give it an infinite range in a minute. And hopefully it is actually connected. Hacked. Yeah. Right. So it's going to be pretty much infinite, I think. Well, we'll try infinite. Infinite first. So hopefully if it works, it should. Hang on. Oh yeah, we need a tag, don't we? No wonder it went wrong. Then this bit should. So hopefully we could try placing it somewhere. Okay. And I'm also going to have it so that the cursor doesn't follow you. Follow you. So when you press L1. Just to make it more easy to control. Actually. Maybe if I remove that output thingy. Okay, so I could try putting it back in. Hang on. Right stick, left, right. And now move it left. Head up and down this. Phew. Finally works. Right. I'm going to duplicate that grass block. Now let's see what happens. Just hold on, before I do, I'm going to increase the maximum speed on both of them because they were looking a little slow, weren't they? Sorry about that. Anyway, so here it is going around, taking down L1, and could try moving it somewhere. I'm going to use a physics tree here on the entrance to avoid collisions. So I think it should be in this page, in object tweakers. No, that's a sardinator. There's a physics tweaker. Collisions off. And whoa. So hopefully by the end of this Worldcraft thingy, okay, think they'll be able to have the ability. Okay, to move blocks around, well, to move stuff around and place them how you want. So I'm just going to make a quick hill. And things seem to be going well, don't they? Okay. Well, thank you guys for watching. Please remember to leave a like and please subscribe if you haven't already. Please remember about new video every Saturday, or if I can't record and need to try, then I'll try uploading even more videos if I'm allowed, of course, to make up for the time I might be away. Thanks for watching and goodbye.